السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. قال الله عز وجل في كلامه الكريم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الجنة تحت أقدام الأمهات. Respected elders, brothers and sisters, Alhamdulillah, all praise and all gratitude is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the opportunity where we can assemble in His house and we can praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we can glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can remember Him. We can remember His favors and thank Him for it. And we also, you know, fulfill the haqq of being here for Salatul Jum'ah. This is indeed a favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever we want to go to someone's house, we always need an invitation. Likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has selected each and every one of us sitting here today, has selected us to come to His house. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, Ya Rasulullah, I love Allah and I love you as my Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After I have completed this, who else shall I love? The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned your mother. Again the man asked, Ya Rasulullah, and after this whom shall I love? Again the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned your mother. Again the man asked, Ya Rasulullah, and after this whom shall I love? Again, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, your mother. And again, the man asked, and after that, Ya Rasulullah, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, your father. Today, as Muslims, what is our understanding when the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam repeatedly said to love your mother and then to love your father? Today we understand it by knowing it. By knowing, yes, this is a hadith of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and I have heard it umpteen times. But how many of us do you practice on this hadith? Today, how many of us today is looking after our mother or our father? Even they have attained such an old age. How many of us are so fortunate today that we have our parents, they are sitting in front of us. We go and we sit with them, we offload or we empty all our troubles and worries on them. And they will pat you in your back and say, don't worry my son. Don't worry my son. And they will make a dua for you. Even though they can't help you, they will make a dua for you. But today, as children today, how it is we repay our parents, how it is we repay them after they have done so much for us. After they have done so much for us today, how do we repay them? Subhanallah, you do not know the joy of a mother after he's being married and he have his kids, and he picks up that phone and he said, "Mom, I love you." We do not know the joy of a mother when she hears that. And we would not recognize the love of our mother until she leaves this world. Subhanallah, everyone knows my mom. She left this world. Alhamdulillah, Allahumma akfir laha, warhamha, wasakinha fil jannah. Also our dear sister, Sonora, who has passed away, Allahumma akfir laha, warhamha, wasakinha fil jannah, who were both mothers. I was sitting there when my mother was breathing her last. Wallahi al-Azim, it wasn't really an easy thing. And I was sitting at her foot. As she was breathing her last. And I was reciting Surah Al-Yasin. And wallahi al-Azim, the only thing that went through my mind was every single thing that my mother had done for me. And today is the last day my mother is going to be here. And I don't know how much I have thanked her for that. Kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut, all our mothers, every one of us, we are going to die. Our mothers, our fathers, they are all going to leave us. And when they leave this world, what are we going to do for them as children? Are we going to forget them? Are we going to just leave them under the ground? My dear respected brothers and sisters, this is why we are as children one type of sadqatul jariya, or a sadaqa, or an ongoing reward for the deceased. It's children left behind who will make dua and they will do something for us on behalf of us. They will receive this reward. How many of us today, we don't have our parents today, and now they are just living as a memory? How many of us today, when we are reciting Quran, we make an intention, Ya Allah, whilst I'm reciting this Quran, let my parents benefit from this. You know, subhanallah, at the day of the janazah, one of my cousins, she came to me and she said, "I'm going to tell you one thing. That one of your door has already been closed. There's one more. You look after that door." The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, "Al-jannatu tahta aqdam al-ummahat." That jannah lies at the feet of your mother. You serve your parents well. You look after them well. Insha'Allah, Allah will reward us for it. A person who frequently, you know, he visits the qabr or the grave of his parents every single Friday, your Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that you will be written amongst the rightful children. How much we are doing today for our parents. And today we think that we are doing enough. As soon as our mom or our parents call and say, "No, not today, I am really busy, can't talk right now." Or we make plans on how it is we can avoid our parents. Because when they see us, they are going to dictate our life. My dear respected brothers and sisters, you will have a mother until you die. Nothing changes that. and you can only have one mother. You can only have one mother. And my advice today for every single person sitting here is to look after that Jannat of yours. If your mother is no longer here, then do not forget to raise your hands and make dua for her. Whenever we are sitting and there's nothing for us to do, raise your hands and call on Allah to bless the soul of your mother. Whenever we are reciting Suratul Yasin every single morning, ask Allah for your mother to benefit from this. Whatever good deed your mother will have done, maybe is giving sadaqah or qurbani, or maybe offering two rak'ah, do it on behalf of your mother or your father. Because when we were a little baby or when we are a toddler, our mother would sacrifice her sleep. She would sacrifice her comfort to ensure that her children is comfortable. Even at time of birth, at that time of birth, when the mother is giving birth to her child, is not an easy process. That's why when this man, he took his mother on his back. It's a famous story, we all know it. He took his mother on his back and he went and he performed Hajj with his mother on his back. And he came back to the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam and said, "Ya Rasulullah, I have done such and such. Have I fulfilled the rights of my mother? Have I fulfilled that commitment that she had made for me when I was small?" The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "You have done all that and still you have not even paid her for one drop of milk you have taken from her." When we were ill at night and couldn't sleep, our mother was there with us. When we were attending our first day of school and we were crying because we couldn't detach ourselves from our mother stood there with us. Even when we become grown-ups and we have our own families and trouble and problems start coming into our life, our mother was there with us. And as long as she is alive, you are none but her child. And she will always look at you as your child. Once the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was returning to Medina. And just before he arrived in Medina, he stopped at a certain place. And he came off his mount. And he stood at a certain spot and he started to cry. The Sahaba was with him. And he started to cry and he was crying. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he cried profusely until he couldn't help himself. And the Sahaba is seeing the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam is crying so much that they also started to cry. And then they asked the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam when they return in Medina, they say, "Ya Rasulullah, we have witnessed something that you cry so much and we didn't know what you were crying for." The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that is the spot where my mother was buried. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he did not have that comfort to grow up with his mother, nor his father. And he was the most beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But yet his heart was still yearning for the comfort of his mother. Today some of us, we have that present with us here today and we are neglecting that. When we become old and we married and we have our family, we have our wife with us, we find that there's no room in the house. They say, "Mom, you need to pack. Take her to her home. Forget her." This is the condition of society today. And it is a pity that is happening with Muslims as well. Even though the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he spoke so highly about mothers, yet still we are so eager to get rid of them. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we are here in this world now. We are going to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one day. And it's going to come when we least expect it. Can happen now, can happen tomorrow, can happen a couple years down from now. But that is something that we will not be able to escape. We have our parents here with us. Look after them. Take care of them. Even if it is, even if it has to be that we need to take away our comfort, or we need to get out of our comfort zone, or we need to, whatever needs to be done, do it. That's why one man came to the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, when the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was going out on an expedition and he wanted to join the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the man, you have a mother in old age, you stay back and you look after her. Your parents has attained old age, it's not important for you to come with me, but you need to look after them. Today we have nothing to do. Maybe an 8 to 5 job, and we call ourselves busy. But my dear respected brothers and sisters, even if it has to be, we need to pick up the phone and call mom. Ask mom, how are you? How is your day? Have you eaten? How are you feeling? That will make their day. You won't believe. That is going to be better than giving them a huge sack of gold coins. You know, when I used to call my mother sometime every day, whenever I would miss one day, she would call me and say, oh, you haven't called me. You have forgotten that you have a mother. She would reprimand me. And then I will reprimand her and say, no, you have forgotten, you have gotten a son. So my dear respected brothers and sisters, look after your parents. Take care of them. Because that day will come when that door will close and we are going to regret it forever. Don't let that day reach. If you can't recite Quran, learn to recite Quran. The Imam was announcing the classes. Recite Quran so you don't have to look for someone to recite Quran on your parents' behalf. You can do it for them. You know, even one brother was giving me an advice. He said, no, even if you just recite Surah Al-Ikhlas 3 times, you get the reward of reciting the whole Quran. Recite it on their behalf. Recite it on their behalf. Raise your hands. Call out on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are in His care. My dear respected brothers and sisters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding and increase our love for our parents. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us, you know, give us the opportunity and the zeal of looking after our parents, inshaAllah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, bless all of our parents, whether alive or who has returned. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, have mercy on them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, increase them in nur in their qabr. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove all obstacles from their grave. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and have mercy on them, inshaAllah. وما علينا إلا البلاغ المبين سبحان الله وبحمده سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت ونستغفرك ونتوب إليك